So right now, we just have one data point for life. It's the life that we have here on Earth, the carbon-based, DNA-based life. What's so exciting to me is this possibility of finding a second data point, a type of life that is wholly different from anything we've ever seen, you know, or maybe even imagined. We try to understand life at its limits, you know, how life ekes out an existence and can survive in places that until pretty recently we thought were just uninhabitable or inhospitable. Most of the field work we do is in deserts primarily, and often volcanic terrains, you know, places that are similar to Mars. It's not a perfect match, but, you know, it could be a mineral similarity, a geologic structure that's similar, a, you know, particular chemical constituents of this environment. It's a place where we can learn how to look. We can learn how best to detect life in these environments, even if there's not much there to be detected. One of the key things that we've been trying to do too is to shift our thinking about life detection from sort of a binary yes, no, to sort of thinking in terms of probabilities and likelihoods and thresholds. This is an idea that I think is central to a lot of our agnostic biosignatures work, is that there is, you know, perhaps some threshold of complexity that only living systems can surpass. And so, you know, if we found a molecule like ATP, and especially if we found it in abundance, like we would be really hard pressed to come up with an abiotic route where you could make such a complex molecule. And maybe it's a bit ambitious, but I guess I maybe got that from MIT in the sense that you should just go big or go home, kind of an approach to science. It's just an incredibly exciting time to be a Mars scientist. We've got three missions arriving this February, one from the United Arab Emirates, one from the Chinese, and then NASA is sending the Perseverance rover. And it's kicking off this breathtakingly ambitious campaign to return samples of Mars to Earth, samples that we think might hold the echoes of ancient life. This idea that we could make a detection and then we could find a second data point and that we could begin to really emerge from our ignorance about our place in the universe. It just still boggles my mind that I have a job that allows me to do these things. We've been really focused on Mars, but now new technologies are allowing us to do astrobiology investigations on exoplanets, even though they're so tremendously far away. And it may be that our universe is just a hatchery of possibilities. And I think, you know, if we were able to study that life, you know, it would get at these big questions of, like, why is there something and not nothing? And did that something from nothing, did it happen once or did it happen time and again?